Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 14th of May. Indian Finance Minister announces soaps for migrants, farmers, street vendors. Pakistan sees record jump in COVID-19 cases with over 1,300 new infections. And hundreds of new nurses join Bangladesh's fight against coronavirus. And now for all the details. India's Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman on Thursday announced the second installment of measures from 20 trillion rupee package Prime Minister Narendra Modi had announced to revive the economy hit by novel coronavirus pandemic. Concessional loans for farmers, free food for migrant workers, among other steps were also announced.
India's Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman on Thursday announced a second installment of measures being taken to revive the economy hit by novel coronavirus pandemic. Thursday's tranche focused on migrant workers, street vendors, small traders, self-employed people and small farmers. She has said in order to benefit migrants, a portal for public ration cards will be brought in and a scheme for affordable rental housing for migrant workers or urban poor to provide ease of living will be launched.
Government of India has permitted state governments to utilize state disaster response fund, which goes from the center, for setting up shelter for migrants and providing them food and water. Just rough estimate that I'm giving you, 11,000 crores were sent in that name.
Meanwhile, COVID-19 count in India reached 78,003 on Thursday.
Pakistan saw a record jump in COVID-19 cases on Thursday, with 1,300 new cases taking the total to 35,788. The surge in numbers came after government eased the coronavirus lockdown last week, saying it affected the economy.
The total number of COVID-19 cases in Pakistan rose to 35,788 after its Punjab province reported 13,000 new infections on Thursday. Death toll from the virus in the country reached to 770 with some new fatalities. The record jump in COVID-19 cases in Pakistan comes only days after the government announced a phased lifting of the coronavirus lockdown due to its effect on the economy and the workforce. But even though the authorities have imposed varying restrictions across the country, as Prime Minister Imran Khan said, to safeguard the income of daily wage workers, the underprivileged continue to struggle while many face hunger.
कोई कमाई के जरिए नहीं बन रहे गरीब आवाम जो है बेचारी और पिस्ती की पिस्ती चली गई है समझ रहे मेरे भाई अब गरीब आदमी जो रोज का कमाने वाला है वो कहां से कमाएगा आपके सामने दुकानें सब कुछ बंद पड़ा हुआ है अब जो गरीब है बेचारा अपने बीवी बच्चों का कहां से गुजारा करेगा जाहिर सी बात है हम भी मजबूर हैं हमें कोई शौक थोड़ी है इस गर्मी के अंदर धूप में निकल के भाई
एट दिस टाइम व्हेन पाकिस्तान इज रिकॉर्डिंग स्पाइक इन द कोरोना वायरस केसेस डेली Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi on Wednesday told his counterparts from the Shanghai Cooperation Organization that the new coronavirus was not growing exponentially in Pakistan, but economic challenge is grave. Pakistan government's handling of the pandemic has been strongly criticized by local scientists and doctors who fear the outbreak will gather pace among a population of around 210 million and overwhelm the country's struggling health system.
Activist Sajjad Raja remembered Kashmiri activist Arif Shahid, who was allegedly shot by Pakistani agents on his 7th death anniversary on Wednesday. He said, the Kashmiris will continue their struggle till Shahid's goals are achieved.
Remembering Sardar Arif Shahid, a Kashmiri activist on his 7th martyrdom anniversary, National Equality Party chairman Sajjad Raja said, We will never forget the cause for which he sacrificed his life and we will continue it with full vigor till the success of his struggle. On the evening of 13th May 2013, Arif Shahid, the chairman of the Jammu Kashmir All Parties National Alliance, was allegedly shot by Pakistani agents at his home in Rawalpindi, and to this day, his killers have not been identified. Shahid was most vocal critic of state atrocities, who always wanted Kashmiris to be freed from clutches of Pakistan.
हम ये अहद करते हैं आरफ शाहिद शहीद के यौम शहादत के मौके पे ये अहद करते हैं कि जब तक रियासत जम्मू कश्मीर को पाकिस्तान के खूनी पंजों से निजात नहीं दिला लेते हम उस वक्त तक चैन से नहीं बैठेंगे और वो दिन दूर नहीं जब रियासत जम्मू कश्मीर पाकिस्तान के गासबाना कब्जे से आज़ाद होगी और हम एक दफ़ा फिर रियासत जम्मू कश्मीर को मुत्तहिद करने में कामयाब होंगे.
एवरी ईयर massive protest rallies are held against Pakistan to mark Shahid's death anniversary. However, Sajjad Raja said, this year it has not been celebrated due to coronavirus, but it does not mean that the people have forgotten him.
The dead toll from Tuesday's attack on a maternity hospital in Afghan capital Kabul has risen to 24. The attack, which shocked the nation despite years of war and constant violence against civilians, is threatening to derail a peace process being brokered by the United States.
The death toll from an attack on a maternity hospital in Afghanistan's capital has risen to 24, including new mothers, pregnant women and babies. Relatives of victims gathered outside the hospital on Wednesday. Some even came looking for information about their missing relatives. The recent attacks in Afghanistan, including maternity hospital attack, is now threatening to derail a peace process being brokered by the United States. The Taliban insurgents, with whom the United States has signed a troop withdrawal deal, denied any involvement in the attack. But that was met with skepticism by Afghan government, which ordered a ramped-up military offensive and questioned the value of peace talks. No group has claimed responsibility for the attack. However, Islamic State claimed responsibility for a blast at a funeral in eastern Afghanistan on Tuesday, which killed at least 32 people and injured 133 others.
Moving on, scores of new nurses have joined Bangladesh's fight against the novel coronavirus amid government efforts to recruit new medical staff. The massive joining comes after Bangladeshi Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina earlier in April announced that the country would hire thousands of health workers as coronavirus cases grow.
Hundreds of new nurses have joined Bangladesh's fight against the novel coronavirus amid government's efforts to recruit new medical staff. Bangladeshi Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina earlier in April announced that the country would hire at least 5,000 more nurses and 2,000 more doctors as coronavirus cases grow. The recently hired nurses have registered for their new positions at the Sheikh Hasina National Institute of Burn and Plastic Surgery.
So, considering the emergency situation and the gravity of the situation, our health ministry has decided to appoint 2,000 physicians, doctors and 5,000 nurses. And among the 5,000 nurses, this institute has got 312 nurses total.
According to local media reports, almost 500 frontline health workers have already been infected, further fueling the need to hire more medical staff in densely populated Bangladesh. As of Thursday, Bangladesh reported 17,822 confirmed COVID-19 cases and 269 associated deaths.
In news from Nepal, the nationwide tally of COVID-19 in Nepal increased to 246 with 3 new identified cases on Thursday. So far, 35 people have recovered from the deadly virus and there has been no deaths.
Nepal's COVID-19 tally jumped to 246 after three new cases were confirmed on Thursday. The health ministry confirmed that two of the three new cases were detected in Nepali capital Kathmandu and Kapilavastu district, while the third case of novel coronavirus has been detected at a laboratory of Bharatpur Hospital in Chitwan district. Meanwhile, amid the rising fear of being infected, locals in Kathmandu have urged authorities to impose strict movement restrictions as they claim the flow of people from hotspot districts into the capital is increasing the COVID-19 spread. Nepal has successfully recorded 35 cases of complete recovery from coronavirus, while three people have been readmitted after testing positive for the virus again. The Himalayan nation fortunately has not reported any virus-associated deaths so far. In a tragic incident, at least 14 migrant workers were killed in separate road accidents on Thursday in northern India. They were heading back to their hometowns amid coronavirus lockdown.
A bus carrying the workers from Western Maharashtra province collided with a truck in Madhya Pradesh's Guna district, killing 8 and injuring 54. While the autopsy for those killed are underway, those injured are being treated, said government official. In another incident, 6 migrant labourers in Muzaffarnagar district of Uttar Pradesh were run over by a state-run bus when they were on their way back home to Eastern Bihar province, said a district official.
Road accident में 6 व्यक्ति जो है उनकी मृत्यु हो गई. वो ज्यादातर 6 व्यक्ति में 4 तो गोपालगंज बिहार के रहने वाले थे, बाकी 2 भी बिहार के ही थे, एक पटना के और एक व्यक्ति जो भोजपुर जिले के थे रहने वाले. तो उन सभी का रात में पोस्टमार्टम कराया गया है और उनको उनका जो डेड बॉडी है उनके परिजनों को सुपुर्द कर दी जाएगी. एम्बुलेंस वाहन से हम लोग भिजवा देंगे. साथ ही साथ 4 लोग घायल हुए थे, जिसमें 2 को आंशिक चोट थी और उनको प्राथमिक उपचार दे करके छोड़ दिया गया.
With India being under lockdown until May 17th, poor people have run out of work and migrant workers have been stranded as they were unable to return to their homes in the absence of transportation. Though many workers have reached home in special trains and buses arranged by the government, many are still struggling to go back and some are even embarking on this journey on foot.
Authorities in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory have started cleaning the iconic Dal Lake despite coronavirus lockdown to maintain its beauty. Local labourers were seen carrying out cleaning operations in Dal Lake, thronged by hundreds of tourists from across the world every year.
Authorities in Srinagar city of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir recently started cleaning the picturesque Dal Lake despite coronavirus lockdown to maintain beauty of the iconic lake. With the lockdown being in place and seasonal weather change, the quantity of weed has increased in the Dal Lake. Labourers were seen carrying out cleanup operations in the lake that is thronged by hundreds of tourists from across the world every year who enjoy rides in the famed houseboats of Dal.
Dal authority ki jo hai ye ek acha step uthaya hai inhone kyunki cleaning ho rahi hai, machine lagi hain, lekin aajkal ki ye jo bahut hi bada bawal hai puri duniya mein, iske sath sath insano ke sath sath jo aapka atmosphere hai isko bhi saaf sutra aur clean rakhne ki zarurat hai.
The exercise undertaken by Lakes and Waterways Development Authority is aimed at restoring the lake and prevent any kind of infections that might arise.
Kuch samay ke liye hamari machines operate nahi kar payi. Fir humne apne deputy commissioner se passes leke humne apni process shuru kari thi. Initially hum pehle 4 ghante chala rahe the, shift hamara 4 ghante chalti thi aur ab 8 ghante ki shift chalti hai.
Kashmir is considered one of the most popular tourist destination in India. Often called paradise on earth by its visitors, the valley is likely to miss hosting the skiers, honeymooners and filmmakers this year due to the coronavirus pandemic spreading worldwide.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.